First, we're going to round out with another Italian piece. It's Respighi's Pines of Rome, and I want to just tell you a couple of things that are fun to know about this. You may have read the little program note. He has a short little blurb about what each thing is. It's got four movements. The first one, the Villa Borghese, it's all about trees in Italy. It's the Pines of Rome. And it's different places where pine trees are, and one of them is the Villa Borghese, where kids play. And there's an interesting little tune that we're gonna play for you. Universal things in language, different things about language that pop up regardless of what culture you're from. Leonard Bernstein then took his work and said, are there things about music that transcends culture? One of them that does is children all across the globe tease each other in what we musicians say a descending minor third. Yeah, 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 yeah. Or sometimes we put a note above it, yeah, 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 yeah. So what you just heard is, yeah, 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 yeah. This whole verse is a variations on a theme of, yeah, 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 yeah. And he's such a brilliant orchestrator. There's also, they play up toy soldiers, and you can hear that it's not just a march, but it sounds like a really toy soldier march. It's a fantastic wild ride. You know, it's all innocent little children, so none of the low instruments get to play. The double basses just sit there, the trombones, the tuba just sit there until it's the second movement of the time for grown-ups, because it's all about trees by catacombs. So of course it's very mysterious, and many times in the score he says, like a psalmody, in other words, like Gregorian chant. And when you listen to this movement, you're going to hear them, the string section, easily all be wearing monk's robe. And even at the beginning, there's sort of a fake Gregorian chant that you'll hear from the horns.
Oh.
Yes, exactly. The third movement is quite beautiful. This is a nighttime scene. In the notes he says it's under a full moon. We have this lovely clarinet solo basking in the moonlight. Very much more Italian than the first piece. And it's a rapturing the beautiful movement. You really pay close attention when you hear that the third movement is transitioning to the fourth movement. He says, a nightingale sings, and I bet we'll figure out when that is. And underneath it, he says, a mist starts to rise. You'll hear the strings. We call it trilling, where we play two notes. And this mist starts to rise, and he says, the poet has a vision. He sees the ancient soldiers, mystical ghost soldiers, back from the Roman days, marching, and you'll hear the cellos and basses.
Left, right,
off in the distance till it says, trumpets blare, which I think you won't miss. Enjoy here from Pines of Rome.
Thank you. Yeah.